Terry George, film director, Irish. I came to Sarajevo to show a short film called The Shore. Over the last 2 years, I've done a lot of US and Hollywood work, television pilots, script rewrites, and it was a kind of frustrating time for me. You know, it's a hard and deflating process sometimes, because you get an overload of input, like notes and things about costumes and stuff from studio executives. So my daughter and I decided we were going to make a film of a short story that had been in my head for many years, since the time of In the Name of the Father. So we went out and raised the money through the Irish Tourist Board and some private entrepreneurs in Northern Ireland. Two guys who run an investment company called Lockshore Investments. And took the money, and I contacted actors Kieran Hind and a woman called Kerry Condon and local actors Conleth Hill. And we basically shot this story right outside my front door in Northern Ireland over 5 days last summer. And it was maybe the best experience in filmmaking I've had. It got me back to that thing of being in communication with actors and the crew, and just focusing on both telling the story and having fun. And the story itself is about two old friends who grew up during the Troubles, were separated and fell out over a woman, and the reconcile after 25 years and discover in a very funny way, I think, that their whole disentanglement from each other and estrangement was due to a misunderstanding. And I think that the subtext of it is it reflected where we are in Ireland today with the ceasefire and the peace process, and not to say that the Troubles were a misunderstanding, but that the breakdown of communication led to a lot of suffering. So I'm very proud of it, and it's, you know, it led me to do another feature film in Belfast, same sort of process, not that big a budget, but group of people getting together to tell a story along the same theme of the new Belfast, where we are today after the Troubles. And I do believe that this is the most powerful medium in the arts, film at the moment, for influencing people and speaking to them, because you can take them inside a situation and let them experience it in a way that newsreel and radio and even theatre can't. And so the challenge of using that medium to focus on stories that move me or that I feel angry about is what interests me most. And you know, while I've taken, in order to fund those stories, I have to, you know, do the Hollywood thing. But I'm constantly searching for stories about what will enlighten people. You know, and a lot of those are very dark and heavy and can be intense for people to watch, which is why I switched over to do these sort of comedy things, which are also about something, say something about a situation. But I go, you know, I'm trying to do a film about Sergio Vieira de Mello, the great UN ambassador diplomat who was killed in Iraq, and something about the Congo. And I'm always looking to mobilize actors and try and tell an important story. The story of Sarajevo, Bosnia, the Balkan War has produced a lot of really great films. No blockbuster yet that sort of breaks out of maybe the independent cinema route. But when you watch a film like Welcome to Sarajevo, or you know, I'm sort of having a blank now at the minute, but I've seen because I'm doing a film where some of it would be shot here and the story is based here, I kind of build up a library of similar films. And I think we've got to reinforce what happened here. And I don't think people have quite got it yet in, say, the United States, that a really modern, hip, very sort of multicultural city could be subjected to what it was, a siege lasting 3 years where they were literally bombarded from the hills by tanks and sophisticated weaponry from an army. And the legacy of that is not over. And you are familiar with the situation. It's not resolved by any means yet, you know, and we still have the trial of Mladic and Karadzic to go through. And so this is a place worth keeping an eye on and telling those stories on an individual basis. And when I come here and bring people here, I try to explain to them the fact that, you know, a woman walking down the street with her groceries could have been shot by a sniper, and children were killed in skyscrapers. That's what film does. It takes you along with that individual who's walking down the street, rather than the kind of the voyeur eye of newsreel, which frankly today, given the proliferation of video and all, has become almost pornographic, in that you have, you know, Taliban filming their kills and American soldiers filming, you know, them shooting up Baghdad and so forth. And it is totally pornographic and has created a whole subgenre on the internet. And you want to go inside and see those people who are suffering and be with them and walk through that. And that's really important to me. And I always try and film to pick someone who is the eyes and emotions of the audience. You know, Paul Rousset Sabagina and his wife in Hotel Rwanda, Giuseppe Conlon, who was played by Pete Postlethwaite, you know, what a fantastic actor, to become the audience and let the audience go inside the troubles in Northern Ireland, or the genocide in Rwanda, or the siege in Sarajevo. So that for me is like the real power of cinema. The conflict between neighbors, which is often economic, but is then disguised as religious or ethnic or tribal or whatever. The similarities were enormous, and when I got to Rwanda, I perfectly understood what was going on. But there are the complexities of the political mix-up and the geographic divide between people. And so you want to make a film to get inside that and explain to people what's going on. And the thing about the shore is, and about Northern Ireland now, Northern Ireland was considered one of the most intractable conflicts in the world, you know, along with maybe the Balkans and the Palestinian situation. And yet, through good leadership and the desire to get beyond the minutiae of the conflict, we have a peace process that's very active and maybe the most successful in the world. And I wanted with the shore just to boil that down to like two people, and that miscommunication and getting beyond that. You know, there's a line that it's all water under the bridge. Now, I don't want to minimize the 3,000 people who died in Northern Ireland or whatever, but if we look to the future rather than the past and try to make a joint future, then for our kids and all, you've made that conflict worthwhile in terms of moving the country on to something better. And so that's trying to spread that word. And at the same time, recognizing that there are real issues, certainly here in Bosnia, and there were in Rwanda, and still are. And you know, the story I'm doing on Sergio involves East Timor, Africa, the Balkans, because he was involved in all of those. And there's a need to try and show that the UN is not a spent force or particularly useless, that there are people, thousands of them, striving to bring about peace. So those are huge issues in our time, and they're not going away. And I'd like to focus on those stories and at the same time celebrate what we've managed to do in Belfast. And that was kind of the idea of the shore. It ends up being funny, I think. You know, I've certainly got that reaction from audiences around the world. With the growth of video, you know, there's a camera now, the D5, is that one, no? It's basically a still camera, but shoots perfect, close to perfect as you'd want for a film, HD film. And so there's the ability to go out and make a movie with very little equipment now. And I think that there are things, you know, the famine in Somalia now, it's underfunded, no one wants to pay attention to it. Everybody hates seeing, you know, these malnourished little babies with flies on their face on TV. It's, you immediately go like that. And the thing the filmmakers can do is get inside that story and humanize it and show that these are real people. They're not sort of dummies on a television. And the best people to do that are the local people. But at the same time, we got to understand, this is entertainment. We expect people to pay $10, £10, whatever it is, to go in and watch something. So you can't, you know, it can't be like going to the dentist. Do you know what I mean? It's gotta tell a story and in some way enliven people's lives and enrich them. And you have to persuade them that it's worthwhile, that those 2 hours will be in some way entertaining. And that doesn't mean eye candy, you know, blowing shit up and fucking having a car turn into a woman with big tits or something. It's a whole other part of the medium that we have to nurture. I remember somebody at a festival saying, don't put your psychosis on screen, go to a psychiatrist, you know? It's sort of, the fundamental is, how do I get people to pay $10 for this? How do I make the money back? And how do I, make it entertainment, make it, and with Hotel Rwanda and In the Name of the Father and Some Other Son, it was to find the everyday, the working class hero, as John Lennon, you know, wrote the song about. Who's the working class hero that we can cheer on and empathize with, and also, you know, hope that we could be that person to put in the same situation? That's what I look for. I don't need superheroes who, like, you know, have rubber arms and can strangle 20 people at once. There are enough working class, you know, local heroes around the world. And treat them then as superheroes to the audience. Present them like that. That's always the challenge. Make money for your financiers and then you'll make more films. So, and I think independent filmmakers have to think about that a lot, you know? Put asses in seats is your number one objective, and therefore think that way from the start. It's a people's festival. It ain't a BS festival where, you know, agents from America and financiers from around the world gather and tell each other how great they are and lie about movies. This is a festival where people, they go and watch the movies, and there's a sense, it creates a party atmosphere in the town that certainly knows how to party, that it's just a sense of cinema mobilizing enjoyment for the people and sparking a party. And at the same time, it brings young filmmakers from all over Europe and the world together and projects their work and helps to spread it. So it's the fundamentals of what a film festival should be. You know, the filmmaking process, the thing that I don't get to do enough is to watch other filmmakers at work. You never get that. I don't know how Scorsese works, or, you know, I just worked with Michael Mann and on a TV series, and so I got to exchange ideas with him and get a sense of how that man works and what he does visually and all, and he's a genius at that. And so that was kind of unique. So when you come here, besides the dinners and all, you're kind of, you know, you're doing some intelligence gathering about how people get money, how they work and all. So it is really networking at a basic level, which makes it so great.